you know, you're building a few boards here and there and it's all new, and then all of a sudden you start getting a real job, you start working at a factory and you have to deal with production, and you're going in and you're doing the same thing over and over again. You're just building these boards and they're just slapping spreadsheets of all these orders, like 20 sheets, and they'd be slapping three or four every single day, and it started becoming monotonous and a drudgery. I'm just going, man, I just want to go home. You know, I'm here, but what am I, you know, what am I doing? I'm in this business because I love to surf, and what am I doing? I'm locked in this factory and I can't surf. But one day I realized, you know what? This thing, what a paradox. I got into this business because I love to surf, and what my job is right now? My job is to get everybody else in the water. That's my job. You know? And so I wasn't really enjoying it. It was just work to me. Okay, now it's another job. The honeymoon's over. You know, this is the real life. Started when I was 14 years old, and when you're 14, being a surfer, wanting equipment, and you're down on the beach and you're seeing all these beautiful boards and nice boards, and, you know, it just took forever trying to earn enough money to buy a board. So I decided one day that, hey, you know, I'm gonna go and start building my own boards. I'm gonna take a shortcut. I had no idea where to start. One day I just got my brother's board. It was a really, really thick board, and I just started stripping all the glass off. I just got a chisel, broke through the glass, and pulled strips off. I destroyed his board to get to the foam. As I pulled strips of glass off, chunks of foam came off with it, but what I had left over was enough to build myself a tiny little board. I remember shaping that thing with, you know, by hand, and using whatever tools I could find in my dad's garage. Got to the point where it was seaworthy. And before I hit the water, I go, man, this board's beautiful. I can't believe it. No one's gonna believe this is my first board. And I took it out, and it was really, even to this day, it's probably one of the worst boards I've ever built. If not the worst. So the way it started off, it was first, it was just a board for me. And then a friend came and said, hey, build one for me. And then another friend, and before I knew it, I was actually building boards for friends and people that I didn't even know. And then by accident, I was in business. You know, never had intended that. I wanted really bad. I wanted to build really good boards. I wanted to build the best boards, you know, around, and this is what I'm gonna do. Quit college and I just started building boards. My bigger family, I've got doctors and lawyers and dentists, and I think they were really concerned when I said, I'm quitting school. I remember my grandmother was there and she was upset. Everyone graduated from college and got a degree. And I'm the token surf bum. I dropped out and I dropped mom. Met some key people along the way that were in the industry that really showed me the finer points in building boards. And the first guy, his name is Ed Angulo. He took me under his wing, and some of those templates you see are there on the shelf are actually from him, you know? Some of the original ones I had. And a shaper to share templates with some other person, some kid, is, that's not something you don't do. It's like very, very private. It's your personal tool. And so you just don't go and share those kind of things. But he just said, hey, go ahead, copy anything you want in there. He just started tracing stuff off and just gave it to me. He was helping me out. And then one day he came up to me and said, hey, Eric, I roughed out some boards. You want to finish these for me? And I go, I'm thinking, me? Are you talking to me? I go, sure, you know, if you trust me. That was like a huge milestone for me when this guy actually asked me or trusted me to go ahead and work on his own boards. And so he kind of gave me a little jump start. And I find out, you know, that's how I need to be, more like that. I need to be cultivating the next generation that's gonna take, you know, my place. I'm trying to transfer some of the responsibilities, and I can get back to my passion and working with the customers and the surfers, the team riders. And through experience, board designers, board builders, surfers can really collaborate and work on designs that really work. I've actually done a board for one of the team riders, and he said this board doesn't even work at all. It's just terrible. And then another team rider saying, what? Let me look at that board. Grabs it, takes it out, and he says, this is the best board I've ever ridden. When I designed boards for Andy, I would not design a board for Andy the way I would design a board for, say, Aki. I designed a board for Aki differently because he's such a heavy back-footed surfer, where Andy tend to be more balanced. So this actually is one of Andy's boards. I was finishing his quiver of boards that morning. I got that phone call. Wow. It's all done, and I only last week I started to deal with it. They've been in that rack, 11 of them, for months. I don't know how many months it's been. So we decided we're just gonna go and finish them. We're gonna give one to the family, and I'm not sure what we're gonna do with the rest of them, but. We can look at the financial rewards of building boards, which are limited. You know, the real wealth comes in the people that you work with, the employees, and the industry here, it's really close. It's a real tight-knit industry. I love this place. Being here, we're in the middle of the Pacific. It's one of the most remote locations anywhere in the world. Living here on the North Shore, and every winter, the surfing world comes right here to this coastline. You know, I get to meet people from all over the world. This business has actually brought me and developed real friendships with people all over the world. I feel like my purpose here in my life is to touch other people. If I was in some other career, I can't think of any other career where I would be in contact with the broad spectrum of people that I can come in contact with right now. They're all surfers though, but they come from all walks of life and nationalities. I know I've been really blessed with men like Ed Angulo, you know, who was so open with me, and I look back to that example that Ed showed me. In return, I want to be a blessing to other people around me. So he set that example for me. For the most part, the guys that I have working with me, my 10 employees, most of them are young. And I can see them, I look at them, and I see myself when I was their age. And they're hungry, and they're excited, and they got big hopes, you know, like, wow, this is what we could be doing, you know, and they have these dreams, and I wanna help them get there. And then, you know, when I'm gone, I hope that they have what they need to start their own thing, you know. You know what, I'd like to surf a lot more. I mean, I surf on the weekends, and every once in a while I take a break and at lunchtime go and hit the waves. But my perspective changed several years ago. I get up every morning and I just can't wait to go to work. I just can't wait because I'm excited to see what's gonna happen that day, who I get to go work with. When it gets to the point where I'm not having fun anymore, I'm gonna go find something else to do. Actually, I heard my mom say, yeah, thought about my kids. All my kids turned out okay. I'm thinking, even Eric. Oh, four kids, even Eric. Yeah, okay, all right, I'll take it.